Yeah.
Your father's a black man, so-called African
American.
All right, but your father's a so-called African American.
Native American, African American.
Okay, so, nevertheless, according to the Bible, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians are the Israelites.
That's right.
You ever heard of the Israelites in the Bible? Come on, I can barely hear you.
For to give repentance. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior. For to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins.
You don't say the whole world.
Chapter 9, verse 1.
Because Christ only came for one people. Christ only came for one people.
I say the truth in Christ. I lie not.
This is Paul. Do you agree? Romans chapter 9 is over the room, right? Paul says, he says the truth in Christ. He's not lying. So he's about to tell you something. He's not lying about it.
My conscience also bearing me witness in the Holy Ghost that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow in my heart. For I could wish that myself were accursed from Christ for my brethren. My kinsmen.
His kinsmen, meaning his flesh, blood, right?
According to the flesh.
According to his blood is what he's addressing in the ring.
Who are Israelites?
Who
are Israelites?
So his flesh kinsmen, according to the blood, is who? Israelites.
Right. To whom pertaineth the adoption?
The adoption that he adopted back to the Father pertains to. Israelites.
Right.
You just said it. Really did. First of all.
Romans chapter 9, verse 4. Who are Israelites? To whom pertaineth the adoption?
The adoption back to the Father belongeth to Israel.
And the glory. And the covenants.
The covenants. Old and the new. Belongs to whom, Tim? The Israelites.
That's right. And the giving of the law.
God's commandments belongs to the Israelites.
Right. Israelites are God's chosen people.
Right.
But they're also God's anointed people that are going.
That's what we're getting to. That's right.
And the service.
We're going to deal with that. Let's say it. Come on.
And the service of God.
Read.
And the promises.
And all the promises in this book belong to the Israelites. Come on.
Who are the fathers?
Who are the fathers?
And of whom as concerning the flesh?
Who concerning the flesh, blood?
Christ came.
So who Christ come for? No, brother, read it again. You're missing it. Come on.
Whose are the fathers and of whom as concerning the flesh?
Concerning the flesh. Remember, Paul said what? My kinsmen according to the flesh. Read.
Christ came, who is over all. God bless forever. Amen.
Yahweh's purpose. We're going to show you. Let's read it. We're going to show you right now, Brother Tim. This is what we're committed to. One second.
One second.
I don't get that
part.
It's not a crime. All right, so why are you bothering us?
Very right, military.
Read. Come on, man.
I got a degree in theology, guys. I can sit there and argue all day.
The book of Luke, chapter 14, verse 23.
This is what we're committed to, Tim.
And the Lord said unto the servant, go out unto the highways and hedges.
This is what we at right here, the highways and the hedges.
Right. And compel them to come in.
Right. To come into the fold. Christ, Jesus Christ. He's compelling the Israelites. Who are the servants? Let's find out. Find out who the servants are. It says, okay. Yes, it was, Tim. There were Israelites over there. We're going to get there. Get service first.
Leviticus chapter 25.
There were Israelites in Asia.
Verse 55. For unto me the children of Israel are servants.
So God says the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you are the servants of God.
That's right.
You are the Israelites.
Right.
Because they fit the curses. They fit the curse of Deuteronomy 28. All right, read.
They are my servants, whom I brought forth out of the land of Egypt.
So now the Bible says that Christ compelled his servants.
And the Lord said unto the servant.
Servant are the Israelites.
Go out.
Precept upon precept. Read.
Go out unto the highways and hedges.
The highways and the hedges.
And compel them to come in.
Compel them to come in. Keep God's commandments and repent. That is what we are here to do. We are to teach a certain people to repent. Because repentance is only for certain people.
Right.
We read in Acts 5. Remember, it said Christ came to give repentance to Israel. If Christ came to give repentance to only Israel, why would I teach another Israelite? Yes, and they will always be the chosen people of God. Okay, let's find out.
There's plenty of Israelites that are going to come first. So I'm going to tell everybody.
You're absolutely right. You are absolutely right. Well, when Christ returns to him, who's going to be ruling? Remember. There's always a ruling class and a lower class, a low class. When Christ returns, go ahead. Right. That's what we're doing right now. Right.
But there's also a white church?
They're doomed. They're doomed.
Right.
They're doomed.
Why?
Because God does not love them. Watch this. Isaiah 14.
Unto the world.
Not who's the world? Who's the world? Who's the world? Who's the world, Tim? All right, watch this. Hebrews 1.
So then what's everybody else here?
Hebrews 1?
So then why God create all these people?
Answer all these questions. Answer all these questions. And we're going to answer it until, just be patient with you, okay? Just be patient with you. We're going to answer one question at a time. So you said about the world, and I'm telling you, the word world means different. Austin 3.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 1, verse 1. God, who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things.
So Christ is appointed heir of all things, the ruler of everything.
By whom also he made the world.
He made the what?
The world.
W-O-R-L-D-S.
Right.
It's more than one world, Tim. That's what the Bible says. He made the worlds. He made the worlds. Get worlds. We're going to show you who the world is. We're going to show you who the world is in the Bible. In the Bible, the world is only one nation. And then we're going to get Leviticus 3.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 45, verse 17.
Bring it up.
But But Israel shall be saved in the Lord.
God says the Israelites shall be saved in the Lord.
Bring it up.
Not in the black, not the white man, not the Chinese man, not the Japanese man. God says the Israelites shall be saved in the Lord.
Read. With an everlasting salvation.
Everlasting. Read.
Ye shall not be ashamed.
Don't be ashamed to say that, I'm God's chosen.
That's
you right. Should not be ashamed of that thing.
Right.
You should be happy that God chose you and nobody else.
That's right. Read. Nor confounded.
Read.
World.
What?
World.
What?
World.
What does God call the Israelites?
World.
God called the Israelites world.
Right. Without end.
So who's the world? The Israelites is the world.
That's right.
You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you are the Israelites. That's and God calls you the world. Read, come on.
The book of John, chapter 18.
Hey, laugh now, die later.
That's right.
That's right.
Read, come on.
The book of John, chapter 18 and verse 20.
Come on. Bring it up.
Bring it up.
Jesus answered him. And I spake openly to the world.
Jesus spake openly to the world, right?
Yeah.
Read.
I ever taught.
He always taught.
In the synagogue.
In the synagogue.
And in the temple.
And in the temples.
Whether the Jews.
Who?
Whether
the Jews.
Always resort.
That's so who's right. The world? Read.
And in secret I have said nothing.
So the world is the Jews.
That's right.
The world is the Israelites.
That's right.
Tim, did you find the scripture that you're looking for? Okay. You need help, we can help you. Come on.
John chapter 17, verse 9.
Come on.
I pray for them. I pray not for the world.
Hold on. Read that again.
John chapter 17, verse 9. I pray for them.
Christ is, this is, those red words, brother.
Yes, sir.
Christ said he prayed for who?
I prayed for them.
He prayed for them.
I pray not for the world.
So if, hold on, if God so loved the world, but then this verse say, Christ didn't even pray for the world.
Read. But for them which thou hast given me.
Who was given to Christ? The Israelites.
That's right.
Read.
For they are thine.
So Christ didn't even pray for the white man.
Right.
Christ didn't even pray for the African man.
Right.
Christ didn't pray for the Arab man.
Right.
Christ prayed for the Israelites.
That's right.
And the Israelites are the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
That's
believe it or not, Tim. Believe it or not. See, this is the problem. The problem is we can never see ourselves above of what society has told us to work.
Right.
God says you're chosen, Tim. God says you're above, Tim. Why in the hell would you want to include everybody else?
That's right.
Why? That makes no sense. Let me ask you something, Tim. Are you married? You have a girlfriend? You have kids? All right. If you go to your girlfriend, you say, baby, do you love me? And if your girlfriend responded, I love everybody.
Right.
I love everybody. What would you say?
We're the bride of Christ.
Hold on. That's the question. What would you say? Would you agree with that answer? No, you wouldn't.
Nah, it's not a
you would not agree with that answer.
It's not a comfortable relationship.
Exactly, right, Tim? Now, if you go there and say, baby, do you love me? Baby, do you love me? She say, yes, Tim, I love everybody. come on, that makes no sense. That makes no sense at all. God only loves one people on the earth.
That's right.
That's it, Tim. That's it. You are above what you think you are. You are not below. You are an Israelite.
That's right.
And it's time that you wake up, Tim. It's time that you wake up and realize that salvation is for you. Redemption is for you.
Right.
Glory is for you. You found it. Come on. You found it. You're not saved. Saved from what? What are we saved from? We're still being shot down in the street.
That's right.
We're still hooked on drugs.
Right.
We're still in the ghetto slums.
Right.
What are you saved from, Tim? What are you saved from?
That's not my salvation.
Oh, really?
Bring it out, Luke 1.
Luke chapter 1, verse 68. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
Of who?
Of Israel.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
That's right. For he hath visited and redeemed his people.
Let's see what the Israelites are supposed to be saved from. Read.
And hath raised up an horn of salvation for us.
Read.
In the house of his servant David.
Jesus Christ, come on.
And he spake as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophet
Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel. Read.
Which have been since the world began.
Come on.
That we
should, that who?
That we.
That we, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Right. Read. Should be saved.
Hold on. 1 second. Should be what?
Should be saved.
Read.
From our enemies.
So yes, if you were saved, your enemies would not be gunning you down.
That's
if
right.
You were saved, the enemies would not be pushing dope, pushing liquor into your neighborhood.
That's
if
right.
You were saved, the our enemies would not be persecuting our Native American brothers in Dakota.
That's right.
If you were saved, but we are not saved yet. Christ has not returned yet, brother.
Bring it out.
Read.
And from the hand of all that hate.
So guess what, Tim? There's people on the earth that hate you, that hate who you are. They hate you. But if you were saved, listen, Tim, if you were saved, you'll be above everybody. Ephesians chapter 2, let's get it.
2, verse 11.
Let's read. Oh, perfect. That's a good scripture. Ephesians chapter 2, 11. That's a good scripture.
Read up.
The people in Ephesus, right? Who are they? You know? Okay, we're going to find that. Come on.
The book of Ephesians, chapter 2, verse 11.
Come on.
Wherefore,
verse 10. Oh, let's start at
verse 10. For we are his workmanship,
uh-huh,
created in Christ Jesus,
uh-huh,
unto good works.
Okay.
Which,
which
God had before ordained that we should walk in them.
Come on.
Wherefore remember that ye being in time past Gentiles in the flesh.
Okay.
Who are called uncircumcision,
uh-huh,
by that which is called the circumcision.
Right, you can't come on. Gentiles were separated from God. The scripture showing you the Gentiles were called into the fold. And if you keep reading, at the time you were without Christ, uh-huh, talking to the Gentiles,
okay,
being aliens from the Commonwealth of Israel,
uh-huh,
saying, okay, the Israelites,
because
it was God and Israel,
mm-hmm,
and strangers of the covenants of promise, mm-hmm, having no hope and without God in the world.
You're okay. Right. God's saying, Gentiles, okay, didn't have a hope.
We don't.
But now, in Christ Jesus, ye who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ.
Okay.
That's the difference between Old Testament and New Testament.
Okay. What verse was that? Last verse you said? That's verse 13. Made nigh by the blood of Christ, right? All right, stop right there.
Yeah.
All
right.
Because you said, listen,
contradict scripture.
Listen,
right,
it doesn't.
Right.
You're absolutely right, Tim. Absolutely right, Tim. Right?
Here we go. The so blood of Christ, Gentiles called into the
fold. This is why they was alienated. Listen, this is why they was alienated from Christ. Watch this.
Bring it out.
Isaiah chapter 1, verse 6.
Bring it out.
And she conceived again and bare a daughter.
Uh-huh.
And God said unto him, call her name Leruhamah, for I will no more have mercy upon the house of Israel.
So guess what? This is a prophecy that the Most High would separate himself from Israel.
Right.
From the Northern Kingdom. Read on.
But I will utterly take them away. But I will have mercy upon the house of Judah.
That's the Jews, the Southern Kingdom. So it's a separation. Northern Kingdom, Southern Kingdom. Read on.
Verse 8. Now when she had weaned Leruhamah, she conceived and bare a son.
Uh-huh.
Then said God, call his name Lo-Ami.
Lo-Ami, come
for
on.
For ye are not my people.
What does God say to Israel?
For ye are not my people.
God says, Israel, nor the king, you are not my people.
Right. And I will not be your God.
So when you go to Ephesians, it says, for you were alienated. This is what he got to
do. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 12.
Hold on. Well, listen, read on.
Gentiles are not Israel.
Listen.
Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10.
We're going to go back to Ephesians. Let's go back to Ephesians. Read.
Ephesians chapter 2, verse 12. That at the time you were without Christ, being alien.
It says, in the time you were without Christ, being alien. Read.
From the commonwealth of Israel.
Commonwealth of Israel. Read.
And strangers of the covenant of promise.
Covenant of promise. We just read Hosea. God says, you are no longer my people.
Bring it up.
Read.
Having no hope.
No hope.
And without God in the world.
God. This is prophecy. They're without God.
Who was he talking to?
He was talking to the people in Ephesus.
Who is he talking to?
Watch this. Read Gentile.
This is a Zonovan Compact Bible Dictionary.
Listen.
Gentile.
This is a Zonovan Bible Dictionary. Of course you don't believe in it. Read.
Gentiles.
Here we go.
Usually, it means a non-Israelite people.
Usually, it means non-Israelites.
Okay.
Usually, but not all the time. Not all the time. Read.
Let me read something real quick.
Now, read who Paul called the Gentiles in Corinth. Let's see what he said about them. Read that. Because you said they not Israel, they Gentiles. Read that. 1 Corinthians 10 and 1.
1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 1.
Read it out.
Moreover, brethren.
Who?
Brethren.
So Paul from the nation of Israel, the tribe of Benjamin, called the Corinthians brothers. Let's see why. Read on.
I would not that ye should be ignorant.
He said, don't be ignorant. Don't walk around in foolishness. Read on.
How that
all of our fathers
were under the cloud.
Under the cloud.
And all passed through the sea.
Passed through the what?
The sea.
The Red Sea.
And were all baptized.
Were baptized.
Unto Moses.
Unto who?
Moses.
So you show me in the Bible where the Gentile Corinthians walked through the Red Sea with Moses. So who is Paul telling you the Corinthians are? Read verse 1 again.
Moreover, brethren.
Who?
Brethren.
What do you call them? Hold on, Tim. You got to answer that question before we go anywhere. Read it. Verse 1 again.
Moreover.
Call it and read it.
1 Corinthians.
Corinthians, the Gentiles.
Chapter 10, verse 1.
Uh-huh. Read on. Read.
Moreover, brethren, I would not that you should be ignorant. How that all our fathers,
brothers, don't be ignorant, all of our fathers, we don't,
were under the cloud.
Under the cloud.
And all passed through the sea.
The Red Sea.
Bring it out. And were all baptized unto Moses.
They was baptized with Moses, read on.
In the cloud and in the sea.
And the sea. So now you have to show me. Is the Corinthians Gentiles? You tell me. Is the Corinthians Gentiles? You tell me. Is the Corinthians Gentiles? You tell me.
Gentiles are not. Listen.
So who are the Ephesians then?
The whole church is from Israel.
Paul just told you that the Corinthians passed.
So where do you get Gentiles?
Ain't the Corinthians Gentiles?
Go
first. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Read verse 1. Yep, here we go. Two chapters over.
1 Corinthians, chapter 12, verse 1.
Read
up. Answer him now with the Bible, because I can't speak my words.
Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren.
For who?
Brethren.
Same people in 10 and 1. Read on.
I will not have you
ignorant.
He said, don't be ignorant again, twice.
Hold on.
Here we go. Read.
Ye know that ye were Gentiles.
You was what?
Gentiles.
You were Gentiles.
So how can you not be a Gentile then? Can you wake up and say, I'm not a Gentile no more?
Well, no, God died. Jesus Christ died on the cross, and then Gentiles were able to come in.
No, that does not change your nationality, Tim.
Right.
It has nothing to do with nationality.
Why don't it?
This isn't about Christianity. Isn't about a bloodline.
It's not. Christianity is man-made doctrine.
That's right.
You show me. Acts 5. Let's read after Christ. He died and resurrected, went back to the Father. We just proved that Paul called the Corinthians Gentiles, and then in verse 10, he called them brothers.
It said that you can destroy them.
Don't walk away yet, Tim, because it made a lot of sense to you. Now you want to walk away. Here we go. I'm going to read it. Read it through, Tim, before you walk away. Read it.
Acts chapter 5, verse 30. The God of all fathers.
Listen, Tim. Read.
Raised up Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Whom he slew and hanged on a tree.
Uh-huh.
Him how God exalted.
Uh-huh.
With his right hand.
To do what?
To be a prince. And a savior.
Prince and a savior to who?
But to give repentance to Israel.
To who?
When the Bible gets real,
I gotta go.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.